and a very good evening to you. It's Sunday, the 26th of March, 2017. It's Mother's Day night, if you see what I mean. Well, I mean, you know, it was daytime earlier, but now it's nighttime. It's Mother's Day night tonight, if you see what I mean. Yes. And we're coming at you on Facebook Live and Periscope this evening. Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome along. How did you get on with the hour change, by the way, this morning? Was it all right for you? It's the weirdest thing, I tell you. Now, I finished work last night at 12 o'clock. I had a few microphone problems in the venue last night. I don't know what was going on, whether it was a slightly flat battery. Every time I moved something, it was over the speakers or something like that, you know. Was that noise coming over the speakers? The slightest movement of a wire. And it was several wires, so I don't know what's going on there. And the radio mic was picking something up, which was creating an awful noise. Anyway, we got through it in the end. And a nice night last night, I was working at Central Station doing the DJing. And I'm kind of background there on a Saturday night, if you see what I mean. The main event is the cabaret act, which last night was drag queen Silver Summers, who's quite young. His name's Bobby, and I worked with him for a few years at Belushi's in London Bridge, which I have to tell you was one of the best jobs in the world that I've ever done. Belushi's in London Bridge. It's like a bar downstairs, and upstairs is a hostel for people from all over the world. Young, mainly, generally, I suppose the average age would be about 25, 20 to 25. Now and again, you get some old gits like me would stay there as well. And they would come down into the bar, and that was my job. And of course, you know, every week we'd have a completely new set of people. It was fantastic. We had regulars there as well. And Bobby used to be just a barman there. And it was all very accidental. And one night he decided to do an AC/DC night, where certain members of the drag dressed up as women, and he was one of them, and he loved what he, and they loved him. And from there onwards, and now he's a drag queen, and I've got to say, a really good voice. He sings really well. So that's what I did last night. Anyway, so I came back home. I have a lovely finish on a Saturday. I finished at 12, which for a DJ is fantastic. I finished at 12 o'clock on a Saturday night. So I battled through the Uber drivers, oh God's sake. And the, you don't see many, you don't see many black taxis anymore, you know, in comparison to the private hire vehicles and the blooming Uber drivers, which are the same sort of thing as private hire vehicles. They were a blooming pain, they really are. Anyway, I battled through all those, got home. Of course, I got home around about 1:15. I stopped for petrol on the way at the cheapest garage known to man, the Gulf petrol station, boys and girls, which is just on the A30 as you come off the M25. To go on the A30, you come down the sort of thing, you get to a roundabout. Instead of going straight on, you go left, and there it is, the Golf Garage. £1.14 a litre. Yes, thank you very much. That's what I like to see, people not taking the mick out of the motorists. Yes. So I got that, and I got home, and of course it was 1:30. Then I put my clocks forward, at least the ones that you have to manually do, because I've got a lot of radio clocks in here. Oh, they're fab. You know, at a certain time, they set themselves. And they go, and it starts going round and round. It's all very exciting. I love it when that happens. And they all do it at the same time in the house. I could barely hear myself think when that was happening. So I got home about 1:30, done the clocks forward, and in particular the one on the car. A lot of people think the one on the car, and they get in the car, oh, I'm a bit too early for work here. You know, and they don't realise you haven't done the clock. So I did all the clocks this morning, and so that left it for 2:30. Now, generally on a Sunday, I get up at 7:30, and I thought that might be pushing it a little bit. You know, 2:30, so 2:30 in bed, asleep, about 3:00. It'd take me about sometimes a couple of minutes, sometimes an hour to get to sleep. Doesn't matter. I've got a lovely, comfortable bed on my John Lewis down feather mattress topper. Oh, yes. Lovely, lovely. And people wonder why I don't take anyone home. I don't want anyone sharing my John Lewis mattress topper. Absolutely not. You'll be able to call in a little bit later on, boys and girls. All right. So, set the clocks. So I didn't set the alarm. I thought, well, I'll wake up a little bit later. It doesn't matter. I'll go to a different church, you know, a different time. Well, the weirdest thing. So if I got to sleep about 3 o'clock, I woke up at 7:15 in the morning. And I thought, well, that's weird. And that was at the new time, you know, the hour ahead, which means, really, I woke up at 6:15, didn't it? Does it? Yeah, of course it does, yes. But it said 7:15. So I thought, oh, no, you know, that's pushing it, you know, getting up now, just after 4 hours sleep. And I sort of lay down. I thought, no, I'll go to my usual mass at church. So I got up, I had breakfast, bran flakes, fruit and fibre. With a chopped up banana on top, got my bike out, cycled to church. Lovely. Oh, it was beautiful this morning. It's the one day of the week that I get up. I class 7:30 is really early. You probably get up at 6:30, something like that for work, do you? Or 6 o'clock, maybe. Maybe some of you are even earlier than that. I cycled through the fields in Wokingham. You know, sheep everywhere. Oh, it's lovely. Oh, it's so nice. This is a live show, my darling. This is a live. Who's that speaking to me? Real Katie Millen. Hello, Katie. This is real. This is live. Well, it might be live. Depends on the time you're here. Is it sort of 25 to 9 where you are? If it is, then you're watching the show live. If it's another time, then it's a recording. All right, darling? A lot of people still getting confused. When is it live and when is it recorded? Well, if you're on Periscope, you should know. You can tell whether it's live or not. If you're on Facebook, there is a little red live thing there, okay? If that is on, then you are watching live. If it's not there, you're watching a recording, all right? People still get very confused with that. Sometimes I do my little promotional videos, you know, telling you there's a show about to come up, and then people start messaging, like, 5 minutes after it's finished. Well, I've gone. It's like talking to someone after they're dead. You know, the eyes are closed. I mean, although some people, you know, they'd still be talking to them, not knowing. Because a lot of people don't listen, do they? Have you noticed that? There's a lot of people on send and not receive. They send, send, send. Yeah, yeah, send, send, send. All right, thank you. Thank you, Katie. Thank you. Right, so I cycled through there and then I got to the level crossing. Oh, no, they're only digging up the level crossing. I thought, oh, how am I going to get across that? And I did see, I'll be honest, I did see at the other end of the road, a road closed sign. I mean, hello? Should have sent a little indicator into my head. But actually, it's the on a bicycle, it's a lot further around if you can't get over that level crossing. So I approached it and I thought, right, be nice to the men. So there's all these men in high visibility jackets. And I shouted in my most workman-type voice. Excuse me, mate, any chance I could get over there? And they said, yeah, no problem at all, just walk it over. And I walked, thanks a lot, boys, all right, cheers a lot. Will I be able to get back a little bit later on? I'll be about an hour and a half. And he's like, yeah, should be no problem, just give us a shout, mate. All right, thanks very much. Cheers, Gov. Like that. Because if you speak to them in the same language that they speak, then I think you get on a little bit better. If you've got all airs and graces and you think you're something else, then I don't think I would have got anywhere, you know. Unless I was blonde with big breasts. Because, I mean, they can get anything, they can. They just shove them out of the window and things just happen automatically. They don't even have to open their mouths. Mind you, I'm not doing too bad. I think I'm growing a pair myself. Can you see that, lovies? Did you want to see? No, probably not. No. So I walked it over there, went to church. That finished about 10 o'clock and came out of there. Level crossing closed again. No problem at all. As I approach, and by the way, while I'm approaching, other cars are going past me. Cars are going past me. And you know that cars are going to get there and have to turn back again. I loved it. And some of these cars, you know, they drive so fast and it's a small road. There was a Mini, there was a beautiful Jaguar, Oh, wow. There was a Jaguar that went past, a Land Rover, and I'm watching these cars go past me. Some of them not giving me much room, I have to say, far too fast. And then, a few minutes later, coming back the other way again. Not me, not Chris Reardon. As I approached there, I got off my bike, said, all right, boys, is it possible or do you want me to go around? No, mate, come through. And the blokes come out And he said, just walk it over rather than cycle, because we've got a bit of a dip where we're digging a hole. And there's like a, you know, the whole length of the width of the level crossing, there's like this, what would you call it? Not a hole, yeah, like a long hole, like a, oh, what would you call it? Like a trench. Like a trench. Well, anyone else think, you know, if I thought that we were about to be a war or something and we're going to hide down the trench. So, well, you don't know, do you? I hope they have their gas masks with them, especially when my sister blows off. Oh, actually, no, that's a lie. It's not my sister. One of my nephews. When he passes wind, it stinks. His name's Gary. I'll name him on the show today. Gary, it's awful. Dreadful. So I wheeled it over there. I thanked the chaps again. Thanks very much, boys. Good luck to you all. And all that bit in that voice. Sorry, I didn't do it then. All right, lads. Thanks very much, lads. Good luck to you all, mate. All right. And he said, you don't want to help us do it. I said, no. And I pretended to have bad legs. I said, not with my legs, mate. I don't think I'd stand up. And they all laughed. They thought it was very jovial. So I continued meandering my way on that little road. Once again, past the sheep and past. There's another field that I have to go past. Right. I call it the field of death. And I'll tell you why. What you see. Hello, Stacey. Greetings, Stacey. What you see often is, well, not often, all the time, you see animals suddenly appear there. It'd be full of, could be goats or sheep or birds. Is it pheasants? Pheasants. People eat pheasants. Last lot of animals I saw there were pheasants, and there were loads of them. I don't know why they don't fly away. Can pheasants not fly? Because they're kind of in this open field, and it's got a fence, but nothing on the top. I don't know why they don't fly away. And for a period of time, you see all these wonderful little animals running around. And then overnight, they just disappear. And you know what's happened, don't you? Don't. It makes me very sad to say those things, darlings. Why can't everyone be vegetarians, those poor little birds? So the last things there were... I think there were pheasants or partridges, one of those type of things. And there's nothing in the field at the moment. So I suppose they're waiting for the next little sacrifices to arrive in a large lorry or something like that. Ghastly, dear, ghastly. Went past that, went along the path, got back, popped into the co-op because I wanted to buy myself some flowers to sit next to Mum's picture. Mum's grave for Mother's Day, that's in Roehampton, and I thought it's going to be a bit mad on the road today. So Mum died in 2000, so I got some flowers just to put next to her her picture or pictures in the living room, vegetables as well. Came back in, and the cat, as always, had left me a large present in the middle of the kitchen floor, not on the area that the newspaper's on. I mean, do you know, it seems to me that I wonder if the cat actually thinks that she's supposed to avoid the newspaper that I put on the floor for her. She's got cat litter tray, which is used for weeing, I suppose, about 75% of the time. Other times she goes on the floor. But number twos never uses the cat tray. I think once in the last few weeks, it's always on the floor because she's very old, the cat now, dear. I don't think she can find it half the time. So I cleaned that up. It's no problem, you know, cleaning that up. You know what the alternative is, yeah? Yeah, not having any of that. Not while she's still able to walk around and seems sort of reasonably happy. Although she is a bit miserable most of the time. She meows a lot. I think she meows, meow, meow, meow. I think she does it because she misses me. I'll be missing you, I'll be missing you. The voice has gone. My voice sounded so much better at church earlier. We did Amazing Grace. Amazing Grace. La, da, da. That was quite nice this morning. So I cleaned that up, and I hadn't put down my new puppy pads. Now, if you haven't seen the show yesterday, it was either yesterday or the day before, Johnny Key, regular correspondent to this programme, and often sends in little news stories. We read one, I think we read his out yesterday, didn't we? Suggested that I purchase from Amazon one-click ordering, my favourite shop. Oh, I love it. Oh, I think I'll have that. click, and the next day a box arrives. Well, sometimes not the next day. I'm not paying for the Amazon Prime. £75 a year, dear. We can't afford such luxuries. We cannot afford such luxuries as Amazon One Click, as Amazon Prime or Netflix. I haven't got anything like that, dear. Not in this house. I spend my money on you. Look at these pictures. Look at this artwork here. £75,000 that cost. £75,000 that was there. Look at my gold, my silver disc. £250,000. I spend my money on you to make it look all pretty. Perhaps I should have a little bit of surgery. What do you reckon? Would that help? Would I look less than 54 if I had a bit of surgery? Anyway, so back to that. So I hadn't put the puppy pads on yet. Now, I bought one up to show you, boys and girls. This is a puppy pad, okay? It's grey on one side. That's the side you have, and you stick these to the floor. It's got little... Sounds like I'm having a scratch, doesn't it? Or sounds like rats. Have you ever had rats in the house? Rats. Oh, running around, waiting for you to go to sleep. Or how about big spiders? Maybe there's a spider under your bed tonight. Yes, maybe there's a spider under your bed tonight, waiting for you to go to sleep. Do you think that's true when you see sometimes stories on the internet of people that have been asleep and spiders have crawled into their mouths? Very scary. Yes. Anyway, so these are puppy pads. Here, it's got a little paper bit here. If you take it off, there's a bit of sticky underneath it. Now, of course, if stupidly like me, you mop the floor first, wait for it to dry, because it's not going to stick on a wet floor, is it? No. As I learn, why won't this stick to the floor? I'm banging away at this. Come on, that won't stick. Oh, yeah, it's still wet. So don't be thick like me and try and stick it to a wet floor. Anyway, once it had dried, I got a few more out. Because you get 50 in a packet. It's about £10.50, which isn't bad on Amazon one-click ordering. Okay? Actually, I think these did arrive. Still, you know that Prime, Amazon Prime? That's the one that guarantees next day delivery. Well, I've found, you know, quite often I order something. I might order something now and it will still arrive tomorrow anyway. Why pay the £75? You know, it's all right if you're not. We're not always in a rush to buy things, aren't we? Oh, I'm not one of those people. Got to have it now. Oh, must have it now. Oh, must have it now. Oh, there's a new telly coming out tomorrow. I must be the first person with that. Who can I order that from now? I'm willing to pay excess money just so that I can have that telly first. No, just wait. Take it easy, for Christ's sake. Take a chill pill. Rush all the time, please. Now, so you take these off, stick them to the floor with the grey side up and that. And I have now covered quite a large area of the area that the cat resides in these. So where C, I mean, I did have a few down yesterday, but she avoided them. You know, she she walked over all these. So there's about 10 down there. She walked over all of them and found an area of the floor that there wasn't one and pooed on there instead. You know. And I've got these nice tiles. They're not flat tiles. They're like those slate tiles. So I do worry that poo and wee is going to get down in there and I'll never be able to get rid of it. Although I must say it doesn't smell, so maybe it's not going through. But would it smell surely if it was going through the tiles, wouldn't it? Oh, dreadful. So they're on the floor now. I put my dinner on and then I cut the grass front and back, and I do like the smell of that, don't you? Oh, freshly cut grass. You can't go wrong, can you? So I did that, had some dinner, watched some telly. Sat in the garden for a while after that because it's been a beautiful day. An absolutely stunning day today. I must have sat in the garden and I closed my eyes for a good hour with my book. I finished reading my book, Radio Boy, which I highly recommend. Radio Boy, okay. So I sat in the garden reading that. I brought the cat out for a while, but she don't want to come out, really. She just wants to sit on her little stool in the kitchen near her litter tray and her food. And when I bring her outside, she just walks straight in again. She's just not interested in anything anymore. Bless her heart. And I've got my quiz ready for Wednesday night. I've already done the quiz. Do you want some of the questions? Look. Who's coming to my quiz on Wednesday? Shall I give you a sneak preview of the questions? No, that would be cheating. No, I'm not going to do that. Just so you can have the £30 bar tab, that's the prize. Quiz every Wednesday night, King's Head Theatre Bar, £30 bar tab is the prize. And it's fun. It's not serious. It's not serious. Sometimes there are serious people come to my quiz. They don't come back, lovies. They never come back because I'm not... How can you be serious in life? Please. There's too much upset going on. We can't be serious. We must try and be happy and gay. Well, happy anyway, happy. So that's the quiz done. And that's it. That's what I've been doing today. All right. What a busy, busy day. Went to bed in the afternoon, got up. I've had some dinner again. And I had a nice corn steak pie, which is not steak. Okay, it's corn. It's corn. And baked beans. And some Angel Delight, not on the same plate, obviously. No mushy peas, no. No mushy peas. I don't like mushy peas. Oh, they're nasty. Oh, how can you have those? Nasty. But actually, the baked beans, I do them well so that they kind of congeal a little bit. I like congealed baked beans. Do you like those? Very tasty. Very tasty. Oh, I love baked beans. In fact, in America... they do bushes, B-U-S-H-S. Bush is like the big bean, baked bean manufacturer over there. And they are delicious. Bush baked beans. If you ever go to America and you come back again, please bring me back a couple of tins of Bush baked beans. Thank you very much. Let's say hello to some people who are with us this evening. Good evening to Rod Brown, Joey Millen. Shania's on the Isle of Wight. Hi, Shania. Simon Gilman. Hello, Simon. Kim Witt's there up in Lincolnshire. Gary Davidson. Hello, Gary. Jimmy Butler, nephew extraordinaire who fixes cars, is with us. Jason Carter's there. Shaun Riches says, have you changed your clock? Shaun, have you been paying attention, lovey? Have you? I have changed all the clocks everywhere, dear. All clocks have been changed, as mentioned at the beginning of the show. Are you just listening to little bits here and there? Besides, why are you still up? You've got milk to deliver tomorrow morning. Come on. Off to bed with your chip. Off to bed with your chip. Tell the test of time. La da 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 da. Hello, Shaun. Dean's with us. Good afternoon. Where's my coffee? We don't do coffee, dear. Vile. Oh, I hate the taste of coffee. And I love the smell of coffee. Can't stand the taste. Besides, you are in the UK, Dean. Tea, dear. English breakfast tea. Well, actually, that Starbucks tea is nice. I think they use black. I think Starbucks use black Darjeeling tea. That's quite nice, isn't it? Don't have any of that poncy stuff. You know, strawberry infused with apricot tea. Or raspberry tea. Don't start drinking that poncy stuff, please. Are you a fan of beans on toast? Yes, indeed, I am. I am a big fan of beans on toast. It was my favourite meal as a child, beans on toast, and I still have it now. Mmm. Yes, please. Hello to JoAnna. Better late than never. What do you mean better late than never? This programme is not scheduled, JoAnna, dear. We just appear randomly. We appear here, there and everywhere. Usually on a Sunday night, it'll be late. Now, actually, what's next Sunday? Oh, I won't be here next. I certainly won't be here next Sunday night because I'll be working next Sunday. We got the once a month karaoke open mic night in Sydenham, so that's that. I won't be here next Sunday night. It'll probably be a daytime show. So generally daytime during the week. Tuesdays sometimes there's a night show. If it's going to be a night show, it'll be either on a Tuesday or a Sunday. All right, my darlings. Good. Shaun. Oh, the one behind me. Oh, my word. Thank you. Oh, I take it back. Oh, my God. I've got to apologise to someone now. I can't believe it. Look, incorrect time is being displayed. Thank you, Shaun. Oh, that's very proud of. I do hate apologising to people. But a moment. Let's just wheel that round to 5 to 9. Sorry about that, Shaun. Thank you so much for pointing out my miscarriages of justice. There we are. Nice to meet you too as well, my love. Hang on a minute. Let's just... How are we going to do this now? Is that coming up to 5 to 9, isn't it? Where are we at? Just a minute. Oh, yeah. This is a fantastic clock. My friend bought this for me. Ronnie bought this for me. And it's like a flip over things. So, you know, when the month or day change, it flips over. I love it. I absolutely love this clock. Let me put this back in. Oh, where was that now? Was it on that side? Or was it there? Oh, dear. God, oh, good here. I could see that come tumbling down, actually. Is it straight? Is it straight? Thank you very much for that, Shaun. I do apologise. I do apologise. If you move the clock hand backwards, you stay in the present. Is that right? Well, I don't think I want to stay in the present. Not at the moment. Anyway, thank you, Shaun. Good afternoon, Ray. Ray says you've still got one more to do. Yeah, very, very good that you're observing your surroundings. That I know I'm not wasting my money when I put new things there because people always notice if something new is behind me. have the clock radio just a second. Rod says... We're talking about ladies. Blondes with big breasts tried to jump the karaoke crew queue. Oh, yeah, I know. And with long eyelashes as well. Excuse me. They go like that. They go that with the eyelashes. They start fluttering their eyelids like that. Excuse me. Do you think I could possibly go up the queue a little bit? And they're like that, flashing away at their eyelashes. Ha! Doesn't work with me. Send over your fit boyfriend. He might have more luck, dear. Oh, they do. They shove their breasts in front of them to get up the karaoke queue. Ha! I take them down another two. Thank you. Hello to Elaine. Good afternoon to Elaine in Israel. Yes, we've done that one. Good evening to Alan Russell, who popped in last night to borrow a cable, didn't you? Hello, Alan. Jason Carter, yes, the clock behind me. Thank you very much. The pad looked good on you. Oh, yes, we did try. I was thinking, due to my IBS problem, I was thinking of actually wearing one of these, but I found it wouldn't go around my fat waist. So that won't be happening, all right? Mark says we put a puppy pad. Hello, Mark. All right. Says we put a puppy dad pad down for our puppy. It most of the time has weed on the floor. Yeah, maybe she doesn't like it because they're quite soft, those puppy pads. Maybe she thinks it's carpet and therefore mustn't wee on it. I don't know. They are a mind of themselves, aren't they? Lee says, did you not put down the doggy training pads? Well, yeah, they are down there now. So doggy training pads are there now. Hello to Warren, who's with us, who says I'm amazing. Oh, stop it, Warren, dear. Thank you very much. I'm not quite amazing. I'm just a normal, sad old man sitting there on his own chatting to himself. How was last night? It was very good last night. Thank you. All right. Okay. So here's something to... Now, often, sometimes we don't get people ringing, which is okay. I don't mind that at all. You know, if you're quite happy to sit there listening and watching rather than talking, that's fine. But it is nice now and again to have a call, all right? Here's something to perhaps talk about. Now, I did see my friend at the moment, Ross Patzer. I think he's actually still on air at the moment. He's doing a radio show at the moment on Reach Radio, which is an internet station. And thank you, Joey. And he's on his show today. He's doing Mum Awards. Now, Mum Awards, perhaps you want to give your mum an award. Now, there aren't any prizes. I just want to point that out at the moment. Don't think you're going to call in and win a car or a holiday for two or £10,000 in cash. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. I haven't even got any mugs left. Or incidentally, if you came to Central Station on Friday for your free mug, sorry, I forgot them. They are now in the car standing by. Those of you, there were three mugs that we've got. I can't remember who they're for now. I know one was from Gustav. Was the other one for Alan? Alan, I think one might have been for you, was it? I can't remember now. But the mugs are now in the car. So next time you pop along to Central Station, come and pick one up. So Mum Awards. Do you think your mum should have an award and why? All right. Once again, there aren't anything to give out. But if you do think that, you want to talk about your mum tonight or just say hello to her, then you can call in. We have a phone line. Lines are now open. 020 8144 3477 is my local London number. Remember, it's a local London number. It is not a premium rate number. You will not be charged £2.50 like when some of you sad people are ringing up Babe Station late at night. And I know the ones. I've got lists of people here from my friends at Babe Station. Okay, I've got lists of your names. Who's been calling into these ladies on Babe Station? I've got lists of names. And if you don't pay, if you're not a good person, I will read out your name. So be warned there. Be the man then. Jerry says he misses his mum. Of course you do, Jerry. Of course you do. But if you want to call in anything to do with your mum, or maybe you just want to say hello to her, then that's fine. 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. There is also a Skype in. My Skype name is United Kingdom Talk. Okay? So phone in number 020-8144-3477, 020-8144-3477, or you can Skype in on the Skype in number, Skype in name, United Kingdom Talk. If, however, you just want to sit there and listen, then that's fine as well, all right? Let's catch up with some of your messages there and see what you're chatting around this evening. Hello to Becky. Becky's just joined us this evening. Good evening, Becky. Bit late, love. Dear me, we've been here now for half an hour? You can't be serious. Have I just chatted for half an hour? Do you know, I don't know what's happened. In the last couple of weeks, it seems to have got incredibly easier to do this. I don't know why that is. I mean, I still come up here just before chatting to you, and I've got nothing to talk about. Honestly, seriously, I sit here now, I don't know what to talk about today. And then I start making notes. Here are my notes today, right? We've done all this so far. Okay, look, see, it's all crossed out. Look, can you see some of that? Some of that, look. Last night, microphone problems, Silver Summers, Bobby. And there's all bits written down. There's a couple of bits at the bottom there. I haven't talked about that. That'll come up in a minute. See, New Carpets Oriental. You've no idea what that is, have you? No idea what that is, New Carpets Oriental. So that'll come up in a minute. So I do bits and pieces. And on my screen in front of me here, one moment, please. There we are. On my screen here, you can see my face there. Your messages come up here. See, there's your messages. I know you can't see that on Periscope. All right, sorry about that. If you watch on Facebook, there's like three cameras in here and they do different angles now, which I'm just... So there's the messages there. And along here, I don't know if you can see up there, there's all these different things. Oh, I know, I can show you. Look, for example, there's a story there about dinners, okay? There's a Sunday Express page. Now, that's something about church organs, and that's all waiting. That's all waiting to be read out. So that's what I do. So I'm sitting here, so I've got my list. Then I get that, and then... Before I do that, generally I'll do a promotional video now. You've seen them. They only last about a minute or two, just telling people that there's a show about to start. Because often people say, oh, well, we didn't know you were on. Well, now you get a bit more of a warning. And that's the whole idea of the countdown as well. So when you see that counted, if I was to start, because it's not radio, is it? You know, you don't know what time I'm going to be here. I'm not here like at 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock every morning or something like that. So it's unscheduled. So the idea of the countdown is, oh, something's happening. Oh, he hasn't started yet. 5 minutes, which gives a few more people time to join us before we actually start. Because if I started chatting away, I'd be chatting away to myself. Well, what would be the point of that? I mean, I've done that enough tonight, today on my own anyway. Walking around the house, chatting to myself. Do you chat to yourself at home? I bet you do, don't you? Oh, you're over there. Sorry, I haven't put that back. There we are. Now, do you prefer this? Can you just watch? Can you just tell me what you prefer? Do you prefer a cut like this? Okay. So do you prefer a cut like this? Right. Or do you prefer, because we're trying to work this out, or do you prefer a fade like this? Okay. So that's a fade. All right. Do you prefer a... We'll do it again. Hang on a minute. Do you prefer... A cut, or do you prefer a fade? Which you like? Please let me know now, and I can set that then. We're on fade at the moment. We're back on fade at the moment, okay? good, let's have a look there. Mark says becoming a bit BBC News. Do you think so, Mark? No, if it was BBC, you know, I don't think they're allowed to smile on BBC News. You're not allowed to smile. Well, now and again they smile, don't we? Who's that bloke on News 24? Oh, the BBC News channel. Simon, that's it. He makes these jokes that fall flat on his face half the time. They just don't work, these jokes that the Simon does on the BBC News channel. Ray Reynolds is on the phone. Good evening, Ray.
Good evening, Chris.
How lovely to hear someone throw in their voice.
Throw it away.
Are you moving that's your lips while you're doing this? It's very clever.
I think you should fade. We should fade you out automatically whenever we feel like it. Fade, dear. It must be fade.
Did you prefer a fade?
I prefer a fade.
Okay,
yeah.
I'll just set that.
This is very fading out. Ray Reynolds here. News at 10. King's Cross.
Oh, you're not faded. How comes you're not? You're not at the karaoke Molly Moggs tonight.
Well, Molly Moggs.
Have you been asked to leave the premises?
I've been to Commercial Road tonight to do the George Tavern with Johnny.
Sorry, is that Commercial Road in Peckham?
Commercial Road in Stepney.
Oh, Stepney, okay, yeah.
Not far from the White Swan.
Yeah, okay.
In there, and I usually go on to the King's Arms in Poland Street off of Oxford Street. But I've come straight home tonight and had a nice early night.
Lovely.
And
I'm here. And we're all together.
Yeah, that was great. I missed the first 18 minutes because you come on unexpectedly.
Well, I gave you a 5-minute warning. I mean, how much more do you want? Do you want me to tell you
other things? We do two other things.
Is it better for me to say, okay, and tomorrow I'll be with you at 10 o'clock? Is that better? So it gives you 24 hours bloody warning, dear?
You sound like my mum and dad.
God's sake, man.
They used to hate me watching my mum and dad. They didn't like television as much as you and I. But,
all right. Well, my nan used to call it the devil's eye.
I know. My nan was the best. My grandma, hard of hearing, she always had an expression. You know, the 6 o'clock news. We used to have the 6 o'clock news.
Yes, and you remember the theme tune, don't you?
Quarter to six was ITV news.
ITV. Right, yeah.
But my grandmother had this expression. And she used to say, I don't pull mine out. I don't pull mine out to quarter to six.
Now, sorry?
What she actually meant was, because the poor devil, she was hard of, not hard of hearing, well, she was hard of hearing, and she couldn't see very well because she had cataracts. And she used to sit on a radiogram.
Yes, I know.
She would sit on the side of a radiogram and the television, she would pull it out slightly so she could see it more clearly. Now, isn't that sad? Out of her armchair or the setting, she'd sit on the radiogram and watch the television closer up, and she would watch it closely at quarter to six because it's more important for her to see the news. Isn't that sad?
Oh, yeah. Well, I've got
the expression, I don't pull it out to quarter to six.
I've got the music to that. Are you ready for this? Is this the one you mean? Is this the one? One moment, please.
Go on, ITN.
Oh, no, hang on. That's wrong. That's wrong. Just a moment. That's incorrect. No, BBC. Did you want the BBC one or the other one?
Go on, there. Yeah,
yeah, here it comes. You ready for this? Here it comes.
Here's the 6 o'clock news from the BBC.
Oh, yeah.
I'm getting that very, very loud. You're a bit distorting there, very loud.
Yes, you will do, because you're on the same circuit.
Yeah. But, I think the period I was talking about my grandma, yeah, she was watching ITN at quarter to six.
Right, yes.
That
was a
strange
before
time,
it,
but
that
was their time for the ITN news, the main news of the night. And then probably it went local at 6 o'clock, probably there. Yeah,
they're all up in arms about it being moved off to 10 o'clock, you know.
Yes.
Again. Why do they do it?
I remember you were talking about that about a week ago, but I remember exactly. They jumped in, didn't they, the BBC, because they couldn't believe their luck when they gave up News at 10.
I know. And then years later, ITV wanted to put it back to 10 o'clock and then had the audacity to say, well, we think the BBC should move theirs back to 9 o'clock. You must be joking. It's like giving you the prize and then taking it back again, isn't it? I mean, how stupid can you be?
There's something we haven't discussed, but I think our listeners and viewers will agree with us. Isn't it irritating how ITV and BBC copy each other?
They do now, yeah. And they never used to.
Cookery programs on a Saturday morning. Do you remember when cookery programs first became fashionable?
Yeah.
I think it must have been about 6 years ago. And so we have cooking now at 10 o'clock. And so the other main channel has cooking also.
Yeah.
And then if you go back 20 years ago, we always had children's programs at 10 o'clock on a Saturday morning.
That's right.
If it was very successful, Noel Edmonds, for instance, they would copy that. Oh, no, we've got to get Chris Tarrant to do his work and copy each other. And then as soon as they lose the interest for a children's program on a Saturday morning, and if they get an idea, like, for instance, cookery, I think we'll do cookery. How original is that?
It's so boring. I don't watch... Do you watch cookery programs, Ray?
No. There's a joke there. You can make a joke and say, I'm not watching television anymore. I can't cook.
The cookery program that I hate the most is that one on Channel 4 where you do the cooking and you have three or four people come round who then eat your dinner and then slag you off to the camera. Yeah. Yeah. Why would you ever want to be on that?
A panel of judges has taken over everything.
Yeah.
Every programme has a panel of judges.
Yeah.
So that's another thing where everyone copies an idea.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's a good job. Become very, very, you know, you get bored with the same thing. So I don't know. I just think it's sad, really, because... originality is so much better, you know, when you don't...
Well, it's a good job there's no judges on this programme, because I wouldn't be I wouldn't be on much longer, would I?
I'd like to tell you quickly. Before I went out at 3:30. I went out at 3:45.
Yes.
And Tony Blackburn was doing a live broadcast.
Yes.
And it could have been you or I speaking, because he said... This is one of the last programs I'm doing for one of the gold programs. You probably know the channels better than me.
Bayer.
He was doing the last one for a certain company today.
Greatest Hits Network, yes.
He said, so I'm going to be playing quite a lot of 60s today. And he said this, and of course this is why I agree so much with Tony Black, but he said exactly as I said about last July on one of your shows, it's a shame that some of the people... who are employed at mostly the newspapers, but most journalists and the media generally, they've got people in the office about 30 years old, and they don't realise just how big the 60s were.
No, they don't get it.
The only time we really see it shown up is if a big movie star, not so much a big movie star, but a star who was always around, if they pass on, sometimes they don't get mentioned in the obituaries, and I think it's terrible, really, but... This is something about getting old, you know, but 60s music, this is what Tony was talking about. Yeah, he was saying how revolutionary the 60s were. It's always the best type of thing. And a lot of the young people, they don't really get it. I do disagree with him slightly because I think the 60s were so popular. I think the young people do get it. And I've said to you, with karaoke, it's rather refreshing to hear very young people sing 50s and 60s songs. I think that's great. Fantastic.
And they all dance to it when you put it on at a wedding. No, I don't do weddings. I don't know if you know, I stopped doing weddings and private functions now. I find it all a bit much, carrying around all this gear and speakers and lights.
That was the main thing I did for 35 years.
But
there are a point I sometimes make is that with karaoke, it's rather refreshing that people know now who Frank Sinatra and Nat King Cole are, and Dean Martin.
Yeah.
There's a good example. 30 years ago, I would have been playing a Dean Martin track for a middle-of-the-road family audience, but we didn't have a karaoke following like we have now. But now, because of karaoke, this is contradictory what Tony and I just said, a person of 30 does know who Nat King Cole and Dean Martin is.
They come and sing it.
That's really good. So I think that's rather sort of saying, well, I knew I was right all along. So yeah. I think that's great. That's why I like karaoke so much.
Yeah. Do you know Graham, who comes into the pub? Graham, he says you sound like a robot.
Me? A robot?
You don't sound like a robot to me. Must be something wrong with his equipment. What's wrong with you, Graham? He
you
works
sound,
in.
Oh, Graham very works much like a robot. When you say
Graham works in Parliament. Graham works in Parliament and was in the middle of the House of Commons when all that business went off the other day.
Oh dear.
Yeah, very lucky to get out of there. Really, I think.
Do I know Graham?
Bald head stands at the back of the bar. Yeah, nice bloke. Nice bloke.
I probably do, and I can't think of everybody. Yeah. Everyone is so friendly, and I know lots of people, but I don't always remember their names.
Yes.
There you are. But there you are. It's nice that Tony was talking about the 60s. I think, really, as I said to you that day, the 60s were revolutionary, and everything was new, you see. Everything was
new. Well, a lot of the songs that come out now have already been done once, as you well know.
Yeah, they've become standards.
Yeah.
That's probably, getting back to the Nat King Cole, Dean Martin things, people like Michael Bublé didn't exist, but of course, these middle-of-the-road artists, they've done a lot for that, you see, because people do know these easy-listening tunes.
Easy-listening
tunes have had because of karaoke.
Yes,
People know those now.
Do you know, I think I'm going to have to ask you to do a new song tomorrow night. A new 60s, a new song for you tomorrow. A 60s number. Well, how about now, let me choose it for you. I must say hello to the ginger girl, incidentally. The ginger girl who's just joined us.
If you pick me a 60s one.
What's that song? Da 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 da. Singing
do
do
do do.
Yeah, right, that one.
Originally done by the Exciters.
Well, you can do that tomorrow night then.
And then Manfred Mann in this country, yeah.
Can you learn that one for tomorrow, please?
You'd like me to do a 60.
I think you should do that one tomorrow,
Ray Reynolds. The thing is, that's why I do George Formby, because I've just said to you, the 60s is best for me.
I'm better
off doing George Formby, because nobody does George Formby.
Well, the stuff that's in the charts now, I wouldn't attempt to sing it, because it's even sung in a different way, isn't it? Stuff like Sia, Beyonce.
It's like, well, you were talking, yeah. You were saying about the talking.
And talking music. Talking music, otherwise known as rap music.
Yes.
Talking
not many
music.
More rapping days to Christmas, dear.
Oh, that's the way it goes. Thank you, Ray.
Thank you.
Lovely to speak to you. Cheerio.
Good night.
Ray Reynolds calling in for London there, boys and girls. Phone lines are open if you want a chinwag. 0208 144 3477 is my local London number. 0208 144 3477. Or you can Skype in if you've got Skype. My Skype name is United Kingdom Talk. Skype name United Kingdom Talk. Phone number 0208 144 3477. Let's just do some of your messages coming in there, boys and girls. Hello to Tom Harris, who's live with us in Chicago this evening. Good evening, Tom. What's it like there? It's been a lovely day here. So nice and warm, it really is. JoAnna says, I believe that all television is covering the same programmes, such as Police Alaska and car repair shows. Well, we don't have any of those here, I don't think, JoAnna. Car repair shows. I mean, they got that, what's that thing on BBC Two now? Top Gear. And I think there's one on Channel 5, but I wouldn't say we've got loads of car repair shows. Maybe that's to come. Maybe that's the next thing. But police shows are quite like the police shows. Although I don't think the police are aggressive enough towards burglars and murderers. No, I don't think. You know, it's all very well. Excuse me, sir, would you step out the car? Now, that's not exciting. What we want to see is motorists who are way over the speed limit being stopped and dragged out through the window and beaten in the middle of the motorway. Beat them until they can't drive that fast anymore. That is the only way to deal with these things. All this poncyness is sending them to prison for a few weeks, dear, where they get fed and they get computer games. It's all wrong. They need to be beaten into the ground. That is the only way to deal with it. Thank you very much. looks like you all prefer the fading. So we're going to go with the fading, boys and girls. We're going to go with the fading. Fading from one picture nice and slowly to the next. OK, so we'll go with the fading after all. Thank you. Yes, fade. There's no one there. Look, there's no one there who says that I should cut, so we're going to fade in future. Thank you. Graham says, I lost my mum 10 years ago and always give her a thought every day. Oh, you and the rest of us, Graham. Yeah, mine's 17 years. I bet it's more than one thought a day, isn't it, Graham? Come on. It is. Yes, I thought so. Oh, she's in my head all the time, my mum. Dad as well, you know, but more mum. I think that's a thing like boys and their mums and daughters and their fathers. I think there's a stronger connection for those sort of things like that. Oh, we've got another phone call calling. Let's say hello to Ray. Good afternoon, Ray, from Morrison's.
Good evening. How are you doing?
Hello, Ray. How are you today?
Yeah, just woke up about half an hour ago.
You've just what?
Just woke up. I came up from work. I finished work about 5 years. Went down to the local Weatherspoon and had some dinner.
Yes.
And came home and had to have an hour's dip.
Well, you're up early. Well, so you've just woken up now. That's terrible, Ray.
No, I finished work at 5 o'clock this evening.
Right.
I went down to, sat down, had a rest. I went down to the local pub, had some dinner, local Weatherspoons.
Yeah.
We came home and had a couple of hours kip.
Oh, well, you do the same as me. I have 2 hours every afternoon without fail. And I have to do that, otherwise I can't function properly. I have 2 hours without fail every afternoon, Ray, sort of somewhere between 3 p.m. and 7 p.m. or 8 p.m.
When you work funny, what time do you start? 10 o'clock? You work funny hours like me, so you need a little rest for yourself.
It depends on the day. The earliest I start is 8 o'clock and the latest I start is 10 o'clock. Yeah.
But by the time you get up to town or wherever you're working, still got to prepare yourself, get everything ready.
Oh, it takes me ages to do my hair, as you can see, Ray.
You look beautiful. You look natural.
Is your mum still around, Ray?
No, she went about when I was about 15. I miss her a lot. But...
Oh, 15. Wow, that's very young age. Yeah.
Yeah, and my dad died when I was 9.
Oh, you've had a hard life, haven't you, so far?
Yeah, but then...
But we carry on, don't we, Ray? We carry on and we remember them in our hearts.
Yeah. I mean, people are rushing, oh, we can buy our mum's flowers. I thought, hold a minute. But they're every day. You don't need one special day. You should remember it every day, not just once a year.
Yeah, that's true enough. I usually have an orchid next to a picture of my mum. I've got some orchids here. I did have some orchids behind me. I've just moved them now. I like to change things around a bit of the back now and again.
I mean, didn't your mum die, was it four years ago?
My mother? No, that was 2000.
Well,
Dad in 96 and mum in 2000.
Well, but I mean, we've still got lots of memories. I always look at photos of them when I can.
Yeah, I've got loads of photos. Loads and loads of photos. And you just look at them and it's nice, isn't it, Ray?
And what I'm going to do when I get a chance... One of my best friends at work, so she can help me put my photos on Facebook for me.
Yeah, put them all on there. That's what I've done. All my photos are on Facebook now, all of them. And of course, nowadays we don't even bother printing them up, do we? We just upload them straight away to our mm-hmm. Facebook things, and that's it. They're there forevermore, I suppose. It is a bit worrying, you know, if something technical went wrong at Facebook, I suppose you could end up losing all your photographs. So maybe it's a better idea to keep copies on your on your computer as well, maybe.
Yeah. So, I always ask you, like, yesterday evening, I was watching telly after work, an advert coming up for Thunderbirds. Do you know what it is?
An advert for Thunderbirds? No, I don't. I haven't seen that, mate.
I was watching that advert show.
Yes.
And they kept saying, the countdown, they put, like, 5, 4, but it just... Goes on to the next advert, doesn't tell you what it is for.
I don't know. Let me just... I can't find... Do you ever move a mouse and you can't see where it is?
Yeah.
Thunderbirds countdown advert. Let's see if anything comes up. No, don't know. No idea what that's about.
Have you seen the one from the New Money Supermarket and the music from Fame?
Money Superman. I used to love Fame, that TV series. Wasn't that one of the best TV series ever in the world, in the history of television, other than Dallas, of course?
I mean, they should put it back. I don't know who would work if they brought it back, because some shows should be left alone.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. They did do a second thing of fame, and it just didn't work for me. The original series was great. The second one wasn't so good, I didn't think.
Is that Grease 2? I've always Grease 2.
You never hear anyone talking about Grease 2, do you?
And Blue Feathers 2.
Yeah.
That wasn't good.
Yeah, never mind. Well, Ray, you have a lovely evening. Thanks for calling in, all right?
Have a good week.
Enjoy yourself. Bye-bye, my love.
Thanks.
There we are, Ray calling in again from London there, boys and girls. 0208 144 3477 is my local London number. Just a reminder, gang, that I can only take one call at a time. So if you call while someone else is chatting to me, I can't take the call, and it'll either just keep ringing or it will go to an answer phone. So now there's no one talking to me now. You can call in now and I'll answer. 0208 144 3477. Tom says it's about 60 degrees in Chicago. Oh, that's not too bad, is it? Are you in T-shirt, Tom? Is it T-shirt weather at the moment in Chicago? JoAnna says the police have to wear video cameras. That's why they don't beat them. I do agree with you. They do need to be beaten. People who are naughty need to be beaten. And Alan says, yes, beat them. Good. Thank you, Alan. All right, let's just click a couple of buttons. Right. So also, I've been watching today the programme about the Very British Hotel. Have you been watching that? I think it was ITV. And it's about the Oriental Hotel in London. It's kind of Knightsbridge. And I've been watching that. You've heard me make a few comments. Particularly on today's show, there were two items that were damaged. There was this carpet. And a family had been staying there. Oh, hang on, we've got another phone call now. Oh, where is that now? Let's see, I'm not quite sure where that is. Hello, who's calling in, please? Good morning, good evening. Hello?
Hello.
Hello, who's that?
This is JoAnna, Evola.
Hello, JoAnna. All right, darling.
How are you?
Oh, it's the first time we've ever spoken. Hello.
Hello. You sound so different.
What, on the phone?
Yes.
Ah, well, that's just the way phones work, isn't it, I suppose? Is it more of a deep, deep, sexy voice now, JoAnna, that you're hearing come through your phone?
Oh, yes, definitely.
Did you do anything today?
I just wanted to say that I totally agree with you with the police.
Yes.
They do. They need to get those whips out and just whip them people right in the middle of the street.
Beat them.
You know?
Beat them.
Beat them.
This sending people to prison isn't doing any good at all. What they do, no. They have more
stuff to do in prison than they would, you know, than anywhere. They have TV. They get to go out and play ball. And they get 3 meals a day. And, you know, that's it. Just beat them.
They need to be beaten.
Get rid of them. And then this
is what used to happen, JoAnna. In the olden days, they would be chained to a floor somewhere, and they might be lucky to get a bowl of gruel once a day or something like that. That's enough. They don't want to go back in there again after that, do they?
No, not at all. That's the way it still should be.
And how about
chain gang?
How about
chain their legs together and get them working and using that hammer and beating up those stones.
Oh yeah, the chain gang,
the chain gang.
And I think you know, for very serious offences, for example, stealing a bar of candy from a shop, for serious offences like that, I think torture. Maybe nails being removed,
off.
That sort of thing, yeah?
Yeah. Cut their arms off. Cut their hands off.
That's what they do in Saudi Arabia. They cut their hands off. They don't have a problem with robbery over there. Funny that, isn't it? They cut the hands off.
We need it here. Yes, we definitely do.
Did you do anything for Mother's Day? Do you have a family, JoAnna? I don't know if you do or not.
My mum passed away when I was 22.
Oh, that's young, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. And I lost my father about 5 years ago. I do. I do celebrate for my mom's day. I have her picture, and I have flowers and a beautiful heart candle that is lit. And I feel really good. Yeah.
Good, good. You know, on my mum's birthday, I actually buy a cake and go and sit by the grave and eat it. Well, not the whole thing.
I do too.
I do have a cake. You do it as well, yes. Do you? Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And it's nice, isn't it? Don't you think that's nice?
It is very nice, yes.
Oh, I love
that. And I converse with her.
Yes, so do I. So do I. Quite often during the daytime, various points of the day, I might just suddenly burst into conversation for no apparent reason.
Well, it's true. I tell people all the time that, you know, every once in a while, I can hear her in my brain. She pops into my brain and says, look, you know, you shouldn't have done that.
Yeah.
And, and when I have really bad times and I'm depressed, she comes in and cheer up. What are you all upset about? This is life. Live your life.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So I do hear her quite often.
I try to work out, you know, sometimes I think I hear my mum talking to me and I'm trying to work out, you know, is that mum talking to me or is it my head creating something that makes it sound like mum? I'm not quite sure which. I know what I like to believe, though. I know what I like to believe.
Oh, me too. I do,
yeah.
Too. Yes.
Good, JoAnna. Thank you ever so much for calling. It's a pleasure to talk to you at last after all these weeks.
Oh, yes, it is. And thank you again for the mug. Oh, it's lovely. Thank you very much for second two out to me.
I'm glad it got there.
After the first book.
yeah. Good. See you then, JoAnna. Good luck, darling.
Okay. Have a good day.
Bye-bye, my love. There we are. Lovely JoAnna calling in from the States there. Isn't it lovely to get people in like this? Just a minute. Just put names in there. That's it. Done like that. Now, as I was just saying a moment ago, boys and girls, I saw the programme Oriental, the very British Hotel. On this particular episode, two items were damaged. One was this carpet. And what happened? Someone had spilt something on it, maybe coffee or red wine. I can't remember exactly what it was. But there were three large, when I say large, about that big, you know, there were three large-ish stains on this particular hotel room's carpet. And they tried to clean it, but they couldn't. Which it was just goes to show, you know, often you see adverts for carpet cleaning and all that business. And I don't know about you, I've bought some of this stuff before. And often it just doesn't work. In fact, sometimes it can make the stain spread even more. Have you not noticed that? Well, I mean, if anyone was going to clean it, it would have been one of these posh hotels. And they had these three stains and they couldn't get the stain out. So they had to replace the whole carpet. Now, when hotel rooms are damaged, then the hotel, quite rightly, has the option of charging you or not. And it went to the camera, went down to the manager of the hotel. And he said, well, you know, their hotel bill... was £200,000. £220,000. That was their hotel bill. Shall I say that again for you? £220,000. I think they had a whole suite, you know, which in this Oriental hotel is so posh and expensive, you know. You and I could never... Oh, I mean, if I sold my house, I might be able to stay there for a week. In one of those suites. And to replace the carpet was £10,000. So they had the option, shall we charge them or not? Because in certain cases, they don't want to charge them. They want you to come back again. But in this case, they decided to charge them because, well, you know, if they pay £220,000 for a room, then they're not going to miss another 10, are they? So I think they charged them for that. And also in this particular programme, in the gym, a mirror had been damaged. I think it had been smashed, a mirror. And it was done by two children. And the mother was just sitting there. She obviously never noticed it happening. But I think the mother was a regular customer. And her bill was £7,000. So they decided not to charge her because, you know, do you accept now and again, if they've paid £7,000 and a mirror was probably costing them maximum of £200 and they're going to keep coming back, is it worth upsetting them for that? And they decided not to go along with that. So there we are, you know, £10,000 for a carpet, dear. God's sake, that's a hell of a lot of money, isn't it? But there you go. You know, it's damaged. It's got to be paid. Someone's got to pay for it. And £10,000, I mean, even for the or for the Oriental Hotel, that would be a big amount to come out of their budget. £10,000, wouldn't it, eh? Some more of your messages. Graham says, what mums and indeed dads have done is given us the tools for life. Yes, indeed, Graham. Mums and dads give us the tools for life. I remember Dad buying me a toolkit himself and he was so disappointed that I wasn't in any interest of DIY whatsoever. I have tried the in front of the wall in front of me here, there are many holes where I've tried to put a shelf up, but unfortunately not succeeded. That's the way you can either do DIY or you can't, can you? Still time to call in if you want to. 020-8144-3477 is my phone in number, okay? Although the lines are going to close very shortly now. George Knight is with us this evening. Good evening, George. Nice to have you with us today. Now, where are we now? Now, look at this. Look at this. I mean, I used to take sandwiches to school in primary school. I really didn't like those school dinners. You remember there's always a kid with sandwiches? Well, I was one of those. Afterwards, I went to secondary school. I went to London Oratory School. And the school dinners there were really something else. Oh, they were delicious, the schools, the school meals at the London Oratory. We spent the entire day looking forward to our school dinner. What was your favourite school dinner, incidentally? Do you have a favourite school dinner? We would have fish on Friday. I don't think we ever had chips. We had that mashed potato. You know, it comes out that. I found a hairpin in it once. A hairpin in my mashed potato, which I took over to the lady. I said, there's a hairpin in here, miss, which she grabbed off me quickly and disposed of before anyone else could see it. That would have been Vera. Vera. She was a great big tall. She weren't fat. She was just big, you know what I mean? Tall and broad shoulders. And most of the children were scared witless of her, including me at first. But for some reason, I took to her and she took to me as well. And I used to get extra food. Oh, yes. We all want, is there any seconds, miss? And these other kids would come over. Are there any seconds, miss? There are no seconds today, lovey, she'd say in an African accent. There are no seconds today. At which point, she'd generally pick up the load of food that was left over because we'd all finished and then chuck it in the bin in front of all the other children. Oh, she was horrible. But, Chris, come and see me, darling. And I'd go over and she'd put more on my plate. I know the people to say hello to. Yes. So school dinners. Well, in the Daily Mail today, look at this. A frustrated head teacher. I mean, how could you send your child to school with this? A frustrated head teacher has exposed some of... I hope not. He can be put in prison for that now. A frustrated head teacher has exposed some of the awful packed lunches his pupils are sent to school with, including a cold McDonald's, and four yogurts and a packet of Smarties for school dinner. The primary school has clamped down. Oh, we've got another call coming in here. London number. Hello, who's calling in, please?
Hello, Chris.
Hello.
It's George.
Hello, George. All right.
Yeah, not too bad.
Which George is that? Hang on, which George?
George Knight.
George.
Hello. Knight.
George, can you just turn me off in the background because it's interfering. I can't quite hear what you're saying there, mate.
George Knight.
George Knight. Hello, George. What are you doing tonight?
Practically helping my mum round the house on Mother's Day.
Well, come on. Work harder, George. You need to work harder.
Oh, I am.
I can still... You're going to have... You're going to have to turn me off in the background. I can still hear myself.
Hang on.
It's quite nice. I've got to be honest. It's nice listening to myself. I quite like the sound of my own voice, George. So you're helping your mum today, are you?
Yeah, my mum's out at my nan's.
Right.
For seeing her mum.
Yes.
So practically, I said to her, see, goes out, I look after the house.
You're a good bloke, man. You're a good bloke. Have you done hoovering? Have you done hoovering?
No, it's all laminate, so it's easy to clean.
Well, have you done mopping? I have to do that twice a day with my old cat. Oh, it goes on and on, dear.
Oh, I know that feeling.
Have you got any pets?
I've got one dog.
Yep.
And four cats.
And they all get on well together, do they?
They fight, but the dog, my big dog, my dog looks after them all, teach them how to control their anger.
Oh, good. Yeah, it's all right. You always find that there's one pet in charge of all the others, don't you? Now, my sister, she's only got two dogs now. She did have once. She had four dogs at one point, and I think three cats. Now she's down to two dogs now. And it's funny. One of them is a great big Rottweiler, and he's got a head like that. He is one of the most gentle dogs you would ever come across. And it's the little one, what's it called now? I think a Springer Spaniel. Springer Spaniel, does that sound about right?
Yeah.
Yes. So she's got a Springer Spaniel, and that is the one that is in charge. Isn't that weird?
Yeah. They are actually the head of their run.
Oh, are they really? Yeah. Is that what it's all about? Oh, yeah. Right, okay.
It basically is, how old roughly is the dog?
What my sister's Springer Spaniel?
Yeah.
Oh. About 8 years, I suppose.
He is
the older one, yes.
Yes, so basically he's the head of the run.
Right, okay.
So he's the head male of the other dog.
Oh, okay. So that's how it works, you know, whoever was there first is in charge, is it?
Yeah.
I understand.
If your sister has the dog first.
Yeah.
The first dog, the second one he brought in, the first one is the head of the run.
I'm with you. Are you head of the run there or what?
No, I've still got my dad in living with me.
Good. What did you get your mum for today? Did you get her anything? Or
I actually gave her a piece and quiet. I went out for the day.
You give her peace and quiet. I like it. Well,
usually on Sunday I wake her up early.
Well, at least it's cheap to give her peace and quiet. Ain't cost you anything, is it?
I thought Mother's Day today, I let my mum have a little lie in bed, leave her to peace and quiet.
Did you do your own breakfast then?
I went out to work.
Tell me, do you remember being at school?
Yes.
School dinners, what were they like where you were?
Oh, my ones were fun because I used to get all I asked for.
You just asked for stuff and they gave it to you. Did you have a favourite school meal?
My favourite school meal in the world was curry.
Oh no, I don't think we ever. I mean, really, you have to remember I was at school in the '70s, and curries weren't really done then. You know, it was all very English. Yeah. Curry. We never had chips. I don't ever remember being given chips. It was always that mashed potato, which I quite like anyway, to be honest. And my favourite school meal was Spam Fritters.
Oh.
Did you like them?
Yeah.
They were nice, those Spam Fritters. Of course, I don't eat meat anymore. Now and again, I have a pineapple fritter. The local chip shop near me does a pineapple fritter, and they're quite nice. Have you had those before? Very, very nice. With chips. In fact, I'm tempted now to go tomorrow and have pineapple fritter and chips to take away. I might do that tomorrow now.
Actually, my secondary actually done the cook there was lethal. She was lethal to everyone. She deliberately stood there, told everyone there's no more seconds.
When there was.
But then she called me up first.
Oh, it sounds like you had the same luck as me then.
Yeah, he went, George, come here, please. I'm like, uh-oh, what have I done?
You thought you'd done something wrong, didn't you?
Just when they call me, uh-oh.
Yeah.
I'm in trouble again. Nick, what do you want? And I used to get the pudding. I used to get two lots of pudding in one bowl.
I think I did as well. I think I had two lots of pudding every single time, to be honest.
Yeah. Everyone noticed when we had chocolate brownie.
Right, yeah, chocolate brownie, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, chocolate custard.
I like the jam roly-poly. Very tasty. jam roly-poly at school. And you know when you leave school and then it's the food is never the same, is it? You can buy jam roly-poly in a shop, but it's not the same as sitting here in the school canteen and eating it, is it? I wonder if I rung up my old school, they would allow me to go and have a school dinner. What do you reckon?
My one has completely changed. No one is allowed in and out.
No one's what?
Basically, if I want to go see any of my old teachers,
yes,
I have to make an appointment.
Well, you would, yes. Yeah, you can't just walk in, can you? Once you've gone, that's it.
Before, it used to be you can walk in.
Oh, really?
Go around.
Where did you go to school?
Rosendale Road.
Where is that?
Turney. Pardon? Brockwell Park.
Brockwell Park. I know Brockwell Park.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's near Stockwell, Brixton, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I know, George.
So
yeah.
On a Sunday, like today,
yes.
I was over at the Brockwell Park Miniature Railway.
Oh, they got that down there. Have they miniature? I didn't know that. I have been to the Lido there once a long time ago.
By where the Lido is.
Yes, they had an event, Purple in the Park, years and years ago. And they had a stage, and I always remember walking past the stage. I must be going back here 15 years, maybe more. And Ultranate was on there. Do you know that singer? Singing Free. You're free to do what you want to be. Yep. That one. Yeah, she was singing. I always remember walking past the stage and she was on, and we went to the Lido and had a bit of a swim, although it was packed. Absolutely packed, that Lido.
That Lido does get packed.
Yeah. But the changing rooms were a bit rank. I don't know what they're like now. Oh, they were just...
They're all the same.
They were falling apart, they were, George. Oh, well. Well, thanks for calling in. Nice to talk to you at last, sir.
And you too.
You have a lovely evening, all right?
And you too, Chris.
Bye-bye, George.
Bye-bye.
Bye now. Bye. There we are. First time talking to George there. Isn't it lovely talking to all these people for the first time? It really is. Okay, right. I think we'll close the phone lines now. Otherwise, we'll be here for 4 hours. We can't sit here for 4 hours, dear. Oh, dear. Just a minute. That's that done. There we are. Can't sit here for 4 hours. I've got birthdays to do. You haven't done the birthdays yet? People are sitting there waiting for their birthday song. They've been waiting an hour and a quarter so far. Graham says, I love the lumpy custard at school. Do you know what, Graham? I don't think we ever had lumpy custard. You always hear that mentioned, don't you, when people are talking about school dinners. Lumpy custard. I don't think there was ever... When you say lumpy, would there be like a lump? And if you bit into it, it would like be powder where it hadn't been mixed up properly. How ghastly is that? Hello to Norma, who's with us this evening. Good evening, Norma. Welcome along. Ashley Yeo is there. Hello, Ashley. All right, Ash. There we are. Now, I want to go back to that story about the school dinners. Merlin says, Hello, Merlin. All right, Merlin. I used to complain about school food so much that my head teacher demanded my parents make me sandwiches. Well, I had sandwiches in primary school. I didn't like the food in primary school. I went to the Sacred Heart School in Roehampton. And there was a particular meal. It was a cheese pie. That was it. It was a cheese pie. And I got this on my plate and the potatoes and the veg. I think, did I have veg? I can't remember. I definitely remember this moment in primary school. And I ate. Yes. What would happen was you would get your dinner and your pudding at the same time. OK, so you'd gone up to get that. And I ate the pudding. And then I went to the bit where you chuck away the food that you don't want. And this horrible old bag, she says, oh, well, I see you've had your pudding. Well, you can go back there now and have some of my cheese pie. Go on, off you go. Oh, and I had to sit there and eat this cheese pie, which was disgusting. I didn't like her. My mum became a dinner lady there as well. She didn't give out the dinner. She the dinner ladies, they like walked around the playground, checking out that all us children were okay. I mean, that was that was in the day before knives, you know, before they start stabbing each other and throwing things and killing each other in playgrounds. There was none of that then. It was all very innocent. We used to play trains in the playground. I was the engine. Me and Gary Manners. We both had a train each. and Tony Busher. We all had, we were all engines of our own trains. And we'd go, ch-ch-ch-ch-ch. And there'd be all these children behind us holding on to the back of our jumpers. Did you do that? Who was the engine of the train? Come on, tell me. What games did you play in your school playgrounds? Huh? Kiss Chase. Did you play Kiss Chase with the girls? Oh, dear. And it funny. Let's go back to this story then. The headmaster at Byron Primary School in Gillingham has exposed some of the lunches that have been uncovered. And they include a cold McDonald's Happy Meal. I mean, how can you send your child to school with a cold McDonald's? Oh. I mean, I'm sure it's okay. I mean, you have a cold pizza, don't you? Or something cold from the fridge. But a cold McDonald's? That's not doing it for me, really. Two bags of crisps and a crisp sandwich. This is someone's meal. This is someone's lunchbox. Four yogurts and a packet of Smarties for dinner. One chocolate muffin, one chocolate roll and a bar of chocolate. That was a child's meal. Isn't that awful? Speaking to Kent online, the headmaster said, we have 525 children at the school and every single child took that letter home and it's been posted on the website about what's going in the meals. So, you know, I mean, oh, it's just awful. The school guidelines are one portion of fruit and one portion of vegetables or salad every day to be included in packed lunches. This sounds very reasonable. Meat, fish or another source of non-dairy protein should be included every day. Non-dairy sources of protein include lentils, kidney beans, chickpeas, hummus and falafel. Falafel, I think. Isn't that an Israeli dish? Falafel, I think, or Turkish, I'm not sure. An oily fish. Oh, no. No, we don't like oily fish, such as salmon, should be included at least once every 3 weeks. No, thank you. A dairy food such as semi-skimmed cheese, yogurt, fromage, frais or custard should be included every day. A starchy food such as bread or pasta, rice, couscous, noodles, potatoes or other cereals should be included every day. Include only water, still or sparkling, fruit juice, semi-skimmed or skimmed milk, yogurt or milk drinks and smoothies. So that's no Coca-Cola, no nasty fizzy drinks full of sugar, rotting away your teeth. You've seen these people on the Jeremy Kyle show, dear. Black teeth and only one of them. Should I say black tooth? You don't want to end up like that. Stop drinking the fizzy drinks. Snacks such as crisps should not be included. Instead, include seeds. Seeds in vegetables and fruit with no added salt, sugar or fat. Savoury crackers or breadsticks served with fruit, vegetables or dairy food are also a good choice. No crisps. Oh, no. No crisps. We must have crisps in our school's packed lunches. Please, Lord, let me have cheese and onion crisps. I can't have any crisps. Not for ages. I can't have any crisps for 3 more weeks. Do you know, it's the 4th Sunday of Lent today, so I've got 5th Sunday of Lent, Palm Sunday, Easter Sunday. I can have crisps and chocolate. Please bring them in on the Easter. Oh, I don't know now. I've got a little bit of a, I'm supposed to be going on holiday Easter week, Easter Monday. I hope I'm still going to be able to go away. The only thing is I can't leave the cat, unfortunately. Let's have a look here. Confectionery, such as chocolate bars, chocolate coated biscuits and sweets should not be included. No crisps and no chocolate. This man is a sadist. How can a child not have any crisps and chocolate in a day? Cakes and biscuits are allowed, but these should be part of a balanced meal. Well, he says, what, not chocolate biscuits? No, Cadbury's chocolate fingers. Yum, yum, yum. Custard creams. Yes. What are those? Orange creams. Have you had the orange creams? They're like custard creams except orange. They're quite nice. Not keen on the chocolate bourbons. You know, chocolate biscuit, chocolate cream, chocolate biscuit. Not keen on those. A bit too much for me, they are. Meat products, such as sausage rolls, individual pies, corned meat and sausages, chipolatas, should be included only occasionally. So actually, you know, I think that's a fairly sensible thing to have in your child's lunchbox, really. I mean, a packet of crisps, cheese and onion crisps now and again isn't too bad, is it, for Lord's sake? JoAnna says a warm McDonald's is bad enough. Can't imagine a cold one. Oh dear. I have suddenly become a little bit addicted to milkshakes. Now, I don't know how this has happened, but I have started drinking a lot of milks. And when I say a lot, I don't mean like two a day, but sort of four or five a week now. There's what's that place? There's the Five Guys ones. Very expensive at £5. Delicious. There's the one at the little chicken shop run by two. There's three lovely Asian boys in there who run this chicken shop. And they do milkshakes. And sometimes on the way home, 12 o'clock at night, I'll stop there. You know, there's no one in there. They're open till 1 in the morning, so I forget they're about half past 12. And as I come in, they know straight away and they just start making it. A vanilla milkshake. And also, and I don't eat any of their burgers, very rarely eat their burgers, the McDonald's milkshakes are always also quite nice. Now, I went for a period of time when I thought they were horrible, but I don't anymore. I've started drinking those, so I don't know why that's happened. I'm becoming a little bit, possibly I need to have addiction treatment for milkshakes. Dean says he was in an all-boys school. Merlin also is vegetarian, same as myself. He says, being a vegetarian at school, it was either strange veggie sausages or cheese pie. Imagine that every day. Well, I told you I tried the cheese pie in primary school. It was vile. Absolutely vile, this cheese pie. And that old bag made me eat it. Made me eat it. Oh, dear. Terrible. Terrible. On a similar story in today's Daily Express, it says the government are not doing enough to tackle childhood obesity and must ban junk food discounts. This is according to the Daily Express today. The committee said that the government's childhood obesity strategy produced last August does not go far enough. MPs have previously made a sense of recommendations to tackle obesity, but most of those were ignored or rejected by the government. One recommendation was for strong controls on price promotions of unhealthy food and drinks. You see, I think all this went wrong when the cooking, making, producing of the food that is sold in that children are given in schools was outsourced, of course, to save money. It's all about saving money. Now, certainly where I went to school at the London Oratory, at that time, and I don't know if that's still the case now, all the food was cooked on site, as it used to be. Every school had a school kitchen. And there, wonderful, wonderful ladies, and probably some men as well, would go in at the crack of dawn and cook your school dinner. And cook it generally well. I don't remember in the 1970s people complaining in newspapers about school meals. But it was all outsourced, wasn't it? So a lot of these schools, the meals are cooked in some great big factory somewhere and then sent on their way to the various schools. And I don't think that works as well at all. It's a little bit like your own home cooking, really, isn't it? You know, what do you prefer? Something that you've cooked at home or something that's come out of a box? I mean, a plastic box. I'm just as bad. Today I had a very nice onion and roast onion and mushroom pie with potato on the top from Marks and Spencer's. It was all right. It was nice. Was it as nice as something I've cooked myself from scratch, which is very rare? No, nowhere near it. I've made corn cottage pies before. So you get corn, which is a substitute for meat. It's a mushroom type thing. You've got corn and you put in a lot of tomato, you know, what they call chopped tomatoes, a bit of gravy powder, some seasoning of some sort, potato on top, shove it in the oven. It doesn't actually take that long. Oh, it's delicious. The only thing is, when you cook yourself, I think your portions become much larger as well, don't they? Do you think? At least when you buy something pre-packaged from a shop, that's it. You know, that's that tiny little square thing there. Does make me laugh. Sometimes it says, you know, serve six on the front of the package. Are you serious? What, six mice? Especially that Angel Delight I like. I think it says serve six on there. No, I don't think so. Six? Two, maybe? I get two portions of Angel Delight out of a packet of Angel Delight once I've made that. Dreadful, dreadful. We'll just click around here. How are we doing on time? Oh, it's 10 o'clock. I better disappear now. Oh, Joey says, what did you think of the pudding at school, Chris, with pink custard? Yeah, pink custard. Oh, yeah, I haven't had that for years. I'm going to have to find... That's blancmange, isn't it? Pink custard. Blancmange. I'm going to have to get some of that. I shall get some of that out this week, I think, with a jam roly-poly for pudding at some point. Yes. All right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls, and we'll disappear. Happy birthday tonight to the lovely Rachael Davis, one of our top Manilo ladies, and I'm doing a little job for her in June? 1 minute, let's have a look there. I think it's June. 1 minute, where's my calendar? Is it in June? Nope, not in June. There it is, July. At the end of July, I'm doing this karaoke night. We're raising money for the Barry Manilow Music Project. And I offered my services to Rachael and Anne. So we're doing a karaoke in Woking in June. I'll give you plenty of warning if you want to come down to that. It might be quite nice. It could be a bit of a get-together for all of us down there. Woking isn't too bad to get to from London and various other parts of the country. So that'll be on a Saturday night, July the 29th. We're still finalising details of that, but that's highly likely that's the date, OK? So Saturday the 29th of July, I'll try and keep that date free, and you can come along to the Manilow Music Project karaoke night, hosted by yours truly, OK? Looking forward to that. Happy birthday, Rachael, 53 tonight. You're just behind me, my darling. Happy birthday. Happy birthday today to Tony Street, to Andy Hurst, who's 52 today. Happy birthday, Andy. Kristina Schletinina is a very young 25 today. Are you climbing up a tree in that picture, Kristina? You're climbing up a tree. Hello to Mark Bonner. Hello, Mark. 43 today. And Chris Finch is 48 years old today as well. So happy birthday to all of you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. On this Sunday, happy birthday to you all for Sunday Mother's Day birthday. Just some messages from yesterday's show. JoAnna says on the birthday music yesterday, you need to make the music louder. Yes, there's a button I have to press for the music and I'd forgotten to press it, which meant you were hearing the music coming through the mic rather than straight onto the system. That's why it sounded a bit quiet yesterday, all right? And Graham, we were talking about robots. We're talking about robots taking over, which they will do. And Graham says, did you know they are even now doing surgical operations with robots? They are even preparing robots to care in elderly. True. Imagine having a robot to wipe your bottom or make you a cup of tea. Your lover may even be a robot one day. And it's true. It's true. Of course. You know, if when we're older, and I like to think I'll be all right, you know, sort of as mobile as I am now for as long as possible, but there may come a time when I'm not very mobile. And if we've got robots to help us, then all well, because we've got a bit of a problem at the moment. We've got more, in years to come, we will have more older people than younger people. And if robots can come along to help us, you know, I mean, there are those embarrassing things. I mean, I don't know if you ever get over having to have someone literally wipe your own bottom for you because you can't do it anymore. That must be really embarrassing. Do you ever get used to that? I don't know. I'm not there, really. But if you had a robot to do it, I don't suppose you'd be embarrassed then, would you? You know, it could do all the work for you. Sounds like a good idea. Graham says, actually, Chris, I'm warming to the idea of having a robot lover to be able to switch off at any time when they get on your nerves. A lot of people switch me off when I get on their nerves, to be honest. We've lost half the audience tonight already, dear. Only thing that concerns me is that during any lovemaking session, there might be a robot malfunction, which actually makes my eyes water thinking about it. Oh, I don't know about that. That's all part of the excitement. See, the only thing is with a robot, you don't want it to kind of do exactly what you want it to do. Otherwise, you'd know exactly what was coming next. Where's the element of surprise gone? We must have an element of surprise in there somewhere. You know, it's like when you, I suppose, like you when you pick someone up off the internet. And you're all doing it. Don't tell me you're not. You meet them exactly at some point. You'd no idea what they're going to do or what they're going to be like. There's your element of surprise there. If it was a robot, it'd be the same thing all the time. Don't you think you'd get bored? Huh? It's why people like this show. You never know what's going to happen next. Johnny Key's gone to bed. Good night, Joan. Good night, John. All right, good night, Johnny Key. Joanna says, my mum was the cook for our school. Real food, spaghetti sandwiches and such. If someone wanted seconds, they were allowed. Oh, we like the seconds, Joanna. We like the seconds. OK, going to disappear now, boys and girls. Thank you very much for joining us on a rather long show today. Well, we've done an hour and a half, a rather long show today. Thank you very, very much for joining us on this Sunday night. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday, and I'll see you again very soon. Sweet dreams to you. Bye-bye now.